Hi everyone, Darren from I-LAN Water Solutions. A lot of people ask us about fluoride. Which water filters remove it? Can it be removed at all? Is it something I need to worry about? Well, let's start with what fluoride is. Fluoride is a naturally occurring mineral found in various concentrations all around the world in rock, air, soil, plants and water. All fresh water, including rain and groundwater, and sea water contain some fluoride. Is it poisonous? Yes and no. What we should be talking about here is toxicity, that is the quality or state of being toxic, and that all comes down to the dose. Pretty much everything a doctor prescribes, or even a lot of stuff we have in our kitchen pantries, can be poisonous if we have too much of them, that is, if we overdose. But at the right dosage, those same things can have benefits to our bodies. Fluoride is no different. At the right dosage, it has proven benefits, but if we get too much, then it can cause problems. So what are those problems and how much is too much? Well, let's start with a little history about fluoride and where we can come across it in our daily lives. Back in the 1930s and 40s, scientists in America discovered a link between a stained tooth condition called Colorado brown stain and an unusually low number of dental cavities in people with the condition, even though they had heavy staining and pitting of the enamel in their teeth. Eventually, someone looked at what those people were drinking and found that the local water contained quite a lot of naturally occurring fluoride, in some cases as high as 8 milligrams per litre. That condition, caused by overexposure to fluoride, came to be known as fluorosis. At its lowest level, fluorosis is only visible to a dentist under the right lighting and appears as faint white lines or spots on the surface of a tooth. At extreme levels, we start seeing that not-so-attractive Colorado brown stain smile. So on the one hand, it was a very exciting discovery for dental health. On the other hand, we also saw the downside of too much fluoride. After a lot of sciencing, a sweet spot was found to be at about 1 mg per litre in water, which would provide the benefits of fluoride with only negligible levels of fluorosis. So from the mid-40s, the USA started adding fluoride to water supplies. The practice quickly spread around the world, and everywhere it was done saw a reduction in tooth cavities. In Australia, we found that water fluoridation reduces tooth decay by 26 to 44% in children and adolescents, and by about 27% in adults, and the Australian Dental Association still very much supports it. So, case closed, adding fluoride to our water works. Not so fast. Adding fluoride to a public water supply may have become completely unnecessary recently, since most of us in developed countries have access to fluoridated toothpaste. It's also in everything we eat that has been processed using fluoridated water. The recommended daily fluoride dosage is 4 milligrams for men and 3 milligrams for women. At the recommended 8 glasses of water per day, with an average of 1 milligram per litre in fluoridated town water, we're already at 2 milligrams. And that's before we've even brushed our teeth, which can potentially add up to 2.25 milligrams each time if we swallow it. This means that a lot of us were starting to take in slightly above the recommended daily dose. And because of that, in 2015, the US Public Health Service lowered its recommended levels of fluoride in drinking water. Another issue is that sticking fluoride in our drinking water is regarded by many as an extremely crude delivery system. For fluoride to do its thing for your teeth, it needs to be applied topically to the surface of the tooth. Drinking fluoridated water still works because the water has to enter the body via the mouth, and while there is some minor benefit in having trace amounts of fluoride in saliva, once it's in our stomachs, it's no longer doing much for our teeth. One other issue is that many people simply object to the government having control over personal health, and they want to make those decisions for themselves. There's also plenty of conspiracy theories and dodgy claims, but we can safely ignore those since there's plenty of good science out there representing the cases for and against anyway. For example, the World Health Organization has reported similar levels of tooth decay and similar levels of declining tooth decay since the 1970s in countries both with and without fluoridated public water supplies. And a Cochrane review of existing studies found no benefits of fluoridated water in adults. Does this mean that adding it to water is a bad idea these days? Not necessarily. It's more that a lot of people are now getting adequate levels of fluoride from toothpaste, mouthwashes, and other sources, but that doesn't mean there are plenty of other people who are not. The problem is more that it has become an unregulated dosage when measured across a population. Some people get a little too much, some people don't get quite enough, but either way, we're still not into dangerous territory. So how much is too much, and what happens if we get too much? aside from mild fluorosis, which mostly affects children with developing teeth and is merely cosmetic, higher doses of fluoride have been linked with IQ deficits in children, brain defects in developing fetuses, and can aggravate the effects of iodine deficiency, which is essential for thyroid function. High levels of exposure to fluoride can also combine with hydrogen in the gut to form hydrogen fluoride, which can lead to gastrointestinal problems, including erosion of the stomach lining, ulcers, and in extreme cases, a painful condition called skeletal fluorosis. However, this level of exposure is extremely rare and not really anything to do with a bit added to drinking water. With that being said, if you do want to remove it for your drinking water, or alternatively you want to make sure it doesn't get removed but you still want to get rid of chlorine and other contaminants like heavy metals and VOCs, what sort of water filter do you need to buy? It's difficult to be 100% certain in a lot of cases. What we do know is that a basic carbon filter will remove some of it. How much will vary from product to product or even how old the cartridge is. As a rule of thumb, you get what you pay for. Cheaper systems, say under $200 or so, are generally going to do a reasonable job at filtering out the chlorine and other basic contaminants, but they're probably not going to do much in the way of removing fluoride or filtering down to a biological level. Products like our EZAC Easy Aqua series are ideal for people who want to keep at least some fluoride in their water while still removing anything potentially harmful, even down to a biological level. These come in two versions. The first is the Easy Aqua 250B, which is dead easy to install and would take most people less than 10 minutes. There's also an under sink version called the 250BU, so you can have everything out of sight under the sink with just the gooseneck tap visible above for the filtered water. It will mean drilling a hole in the sink, so it's a little more difficult to install. We also have the Alia FF5800, which goes straight on the tap. While it doesn't offer the same level of filtration as the EZAC systems, it's a less expensive option and nice and compact. There's also shower filters if you want to remove chlorine out of your shower water. I don't expect these will do much for fluoride, but then a little bit of fluoride in your shower water isn't likely to be a problem anyway. For those who want to get rid of as much fluoride as possible, a reverse osmosis system is the way to go. Products like our Alia ROC 188 and 189 or our Clean Pure RO 2000 would be ideal. For details about all of those products and more, please visit our website at www.ilanwater.com.au. If you have any questions, please feel welcome to call us on 02-8840-5177 or email sales@ilanwater.com.au. Or if you go to our website, you can talk to us using the chat box at the bottom right of the page, or visit us on Facebook and message us there. Please like and subscribe below and leave a comment if you agree or disagree with anything I've said. Bye for now.